Okay, this is my new 2015 Nash 25C, and I am going to install 240-watt Kyocera solar panels on it. Okay, it already has a 20-watt ZAMP, which is basically useless other than maintaining batteries and storage. So I'm going to be adding 240-watt panels, and I'm going to show you guys how you can do it with this trailer, and this applies to a lot of Northwood products. Okay, what you're gonna need for this, I've got a Blue Sky 30 amp, this is a PWM charge controller, okay, but it is a very good PWM controller. It has ability to set charge points, which is very good. Some of them you cannot do that, and if you have good batteries, like I've got two Trojan 6-volt T105s, so I can set the proper charge points with that guy. Obviously the charge controller that comes with this trailer is only a 7 amp and is not going to do the job for the amount of wattage of panels I'm going to be putting on the roof. So other things we're going to need is a piece of paper, pencil, scissors, and some tape. That's to make the template for this guy, so that when we're cutting the wall open to put that in. I'm going to need some, I'm using 8 gauge wire here. This stuff is not UV coated or anything. It's very hard for me to get UV coated wire in Canada here. Pretty much impossible, I can't find it anywhere. So what I'm going to be doing is using, this is like automotive amplifier wire, copper wire, and I'm going to put it in wire protector on the roof, so which will keep the sun's rays off of it, keep the wire cooler, and that's how I'm going to do that. It'll give it a clean look as well. I'm going to want some heat shrink tubing. I've got a fuse holder for two fuses and some 25 amp fuses, and that's to fuse the solar panels from the roof and then the line going to the battery, okay, or the batteries. Soldering iron and solder for connecting wires properly. You know, you could use connectors instead of that, but I like to do things so that there's no chance of them coming apart. And then miscellaneous tools like wire cutters and screwdrivers. I've got some electrical tape that's going to be to join these two wires together so they're not all over the place. Then like the solar panels I've got outside right now, but we'll have a look at those later. Okay, before we go any further, you're gonna want to make sure that we disconnect electricity. If you're plugged in, for sure do that. And unhook the battery. Okay. You know, take the positive lead off the battery. Okay, and verify inside, like turn on a fan or lights or something to make sure that there's no power in the trailer. You don't want to have these, you don't want to accidentally touch some wires together and get some sparks going. I'm also going to, like right now I've got the ZAMP solar, which is signified by these. I'm going to disconnect those, both those leads completely from the battery. Okay, so the positive and negative side. If you have two 12s, make sure you disconnect both the positive and negative of everything off both your batteries or however many batteries you have. If you just have, I just have 2 6-volts up here. One easy way to kill all power is just remove your cable for the serial connection from your positive to negative post over on the other battery. So if I just remove that, well, there's no connection between those two batteries anymore, and there's no power, okay? So that's just an easy thing to do with 6 volts. Two of them. If you have more, well, you're gonna be, you know, disconnecting more than one of those. So if you turn over the controller, now your controller might not be a flush-mounted, like this is a flush-mounted controller. So as you can see on the back, there's a lot of space here, and this is going to mount flush into the cabinet. Some of them will protrude out of the cabinet, so that, you know, you may or may not have to do what I'm doing here. It depends on the controller you have. But what I did is I put a sheet of paper on top of here, like the whole sheet, and I used a pencil or a pencil crayon, and I just traced around the edges of that to get it to figure out where the line was. And then I cut it out and I taped it up here where I want to put this where I want to put this controller. And it's just on the cabinet right where, so I've already got this thing out. This is the Northwood control center. It comes out with 6 screws. It allows you to get at all these wires, okay, which, you know, this is the way I would install it if I was you. It lets you get in here. I'm going to drill in where my hands are. I'm going to drill into this cabinet and put it over here. If you had a very small charge controller like the Zamp, you know, you might want to just remove it and put it right here, but the Blue Sky one is too big for this space here. It's too large, so I have to put it up here. Okay, so I'm going to be drilling in over to here to get my solar wires, which are actually right here. So everything for this solar system is going to be very straightforward. All the entire coach is pre-wired. When I talked to Northwood, they told me that the entire solar system was 8 gauge, which I was happy with, but they are not right. We have 10 gauge coming from the roof, from the solar. There's a SAE2 connector sitting up on the roof, and then the 20 watt ZAMP panel is actually just pigtailed into it somewhere in the ceiling, like by this air conditioner is tied into it. So they're actually only got 10 gauge wire from the roof down, but it's still sufficient for the amount of wattage I'm putting on. But it's too bad that they didn't use 8 gauge up there as well. Now to the batteries, they're using 8 gauge wire, which is good because it's a longer run. It's probably about 12 to 15 feet, I would say, of a run. So having that 8 gauge wire to the battery is really good. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to cut my template that I've taped up here. I'm going to just cut this with a Dremel tool. And yeah, it's a little bit nerve-wracking chopping up your brand new trailer, but hey, if you want something done right, you might as well do it yourself. So I'm going to be doing that next. Okay, I've cut that hole with my Dremel tool here, okay? So just along the template line. So now I can take this paper off, put the controller in, okay? And in this cabinet here, there's enough light, you'll be able to see that I'm going to drill basically right here. I'm going to put a hole in here to get those solar wires to go into the side of the controller. Okay. Okay, we'll just put this guy in there, make sure that he fits, see what he looks like. It's nice and snug, level at the top there. So that's how she's going to look hooked up. Okay. Pop her back out so I'm going to drill that hole behind. Okay, I drilled a 5/8 hole right there. Okay, and you know, this step is only necessary if you're putting the controller somewhere, you know, a little different, right? If you're going to be able to fit it in where I said, if you had a smaller one, then you can do it in that other box. So the wires are here, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to mount this fuse block, I think right about here. So what I want to do is I'm going to take the positive lead from both the battery connection and the solar panel connection. So one will be for battery, one will be for solar, and then I'll have a new wire going from the other side to the charge controller. So I'm going to solder that up right now. Okay, there she is, the little fuse block in place. I'm going to throw 2 25 amp fuses, so that'll pop those if it ever goes over 25 amps. The system's really only capable of about 16 or 17. So that's just a safety measure. I highly recommend fusing your solar system, whether you do it here or like right at the panel and right at the battery. It really this is just an easy place for me to check the fuses. Okay, I don't have to like go up on the roof and check them. Now the Zamp Solar in this Nash, the 20 watt on the roof has a fuse right. They put it on the air conditioner and the fuse is right next to it. You'll see it. I recommend unhooking that fuse before carrying on. Okay, I did that, but I forgot to bring the camera out there. I might show you where it is later. That way there's no power from the solar, that little solar panel, when you hook up your charge controller. So right now I'm going to put the charge controller in that hole and we're going to hook up these wires. So I'll just kind of explain here. This wire here, the smaller 10 gauge, that one there is from the solar panel or panels from the roof. And this one here will go to the solar positive lead in on the controller. And this one here is to the battery. This will go into the battery one. Okay, so both positive leads are fused. Okay, and the negative leads do not have to be fused. I should mention too, I do not have the fuses in place and I'm going to leave it that way until after the solar panels are installed. That way I can wire those panels and not have to worry about doing any damage to the controller by if I mess something up, or you know, it's just a precautionary thing. Leave the fuses out so that connection is not connected while the fuses are out. Okay, there she is all hooked up. Okay, so you can, let me see if I can explain what's going on here. Like, you know, depending on the charge controller you use, but you're gonna have a positive and a negative going to the battery, which are these top ones, okay? So I know this thicker wire here, that's the battery positive, battery negative. And then these thinner ones, the 10 gauge, positive and negative are going from the solar panels into here. There's leads out here for a temperature sensor on the batteries, which is highly recommended, especially if you're having to run your own wires for some reason. It's going to be a pain for me to do it. I'm not going to do it right now, but in the future I may connect that because it does give your batteries a better charge, especially in the winter time and stuff like that. Okay. So, but there it all is, all cleaned up, screwed in, and I'll just show you the other side here. So that's where she looks, and it's not on yet because, you know, I don't have the fuses in, and the power of the trailer is completely cut still. So I'm going to put this Northwood monitor center back up in that hole. I'm done in here. Okay, these wires here are for this thing, and I can't, fortunately, I have to leave that up there because the way that they wire this goofy thing is they just drill some holes here. There's one there and one there. So if I took that off, this thing would just be an ugly bunch of holes. So unless I can cover it with something. So I'm just going to leave it unhooked and leave it in there. Okay, these are cheap and it's fine for the job that little 20 watt was doing. Or maybe if you wanted to have maybe just add a 100 watt panel, well, you could just keep using this charge controller because it's good for up to 7 amps, so it's about 120 watts, 110 watts, so you could make do with that if you're only adding a little bit of solar instead of adding a whole new charge controller like I did. Okay, so these wires I'm just going to tuck in there, and then maybe down the road if I figure out what I'm going to do here, I can just yank this out. The wires will come with it, and I can put something over that hole. Or, like I said, I'm just going to leave it. It just looks like a black box. Okay, so we'll put this thing back up, and we're done inside. So next thing to do is to go up on the roof and figuring out these solar panels on the roof.